Dear students, today topic is introduction to polymer, homomer, copolymer and degree of polymerization. I, Suparna Vishwas, lecturer in the Department of Electrochemical Engineering, Dr. MSIT, Haldia. So, introduction to polymer. What are polymers? Many small molecules called monomers by combining together with by the process called polymerization and give the product which is called the polymer. So monomer goes with the process polymerization and give product polymer. Now poly means many and mar means units. Poly is a Greek word, so when we combining poly and mar, that is many units. So materials made up of many units called polymers. Now by definition, polymer is a large molecule consisting of a number of repeating units with molecular weight typically several thousands or higher. So when the molecular weight of a polymer is thousand or higher, of a molecule thousands or higher, is called a polymer. Now the repeating unit is the fundamental recurring unit of a polymer. That means the repeating, by repeatedly coming the units, is called the repeating units. That is the base of the polymer. And monomer is the smallest molecule that are used to prepare the polymer. So many monomers combining together and gives the product polymer. Oligomer. There is a difference between oligomer and a polymer. Actually, by definition, you can see the polymer, molecular weight of polymer is thousands or higher. But in oligomer, is a molecule consisting of reaction of several repeating units of a monomer, but not large enough like polymer. And it is mainly dimer, trimer, tetramer, pentamer, etc., not more than that. Now the degree of polymerization means number of repeating units, that is the degree of polymerization. Now the classification by monomer composition. So we can classify it a polymer by two ways, that is homomer and copolymer. And homopolymer means consist of only one type of constitutional repeating unit, like A. Means only A is the repeating unit, that is A is the monomer, and we get the polymer if combining A, like AAAA in this picture you can see it. And copolymer is consist of two or more constitutional repeating unit, that is A and B. Okay, A and B, two monomers that is constitutionally repeating, that is you can see here, that is AB, AB, like this. Now several classes of copolymers. There is statistical copolymer, means random copolymer. When two or more different monomers, situated at a randomly. Here randomness is present. That means A B A A B B B A, like there is no sequence. Now the alternating copolymer, made up of alternating sequence of the different monomers, like A B A B A B, like this. Now the block copolymer, there is a long sequence of monomer, one type of monomer, followed by a long sequence of another monomer. So, like 5 numbers of A and then 5 numbers of B, like this. Now the graft copolymer. Graft copolymer means a chain made from one monomers with the branches of other. Means A means a long chain made up of monomer A and the branches with the long chain made up of monomer B. So this is called the graft copolymer. So these are the types of copolymers. Okay. And the next one is classification by chain structure, that is molecular architecture. These are mainly 4 types: linear chain polymers, that is repeating units are like a single continuous chain, that means a linear, that is the monomer lie as a linear position. Okay, now the branched chain polymers, that is side chains of repeat units connecting with the main chain repeat units, that means they are the linear polymer chain polymer and a branched type of polymer monomer is situated as a branched way. Okay, that means linear and there is some branches are present. This is called branch chain polymers. Now the cross-linked polymers. Cross-linked polymers consist of interconnections between the chains. That means linear polymers. Okay, there is a number of linear polymers and there is an interconnection between the polymers, cross-linked polymers. Network polymers, in the pictures you can see the network polymers. Now the stereoisomerism or tacticity. There are 3 type of tacticity mainly. Now the first one, isotactic. All the substituents lie on one side of the chain. The configuration is called isotactic. In this picture you can see the blue bullets is one type of monomer and it is lie on the one side. Okay, and there is a green bullets, that is the one type of another type of monomer and lie on the other side. So this is a isotactic polymers. Now the syngeotactic polymers. All substituents alternate from one side to another in a regular manner. The configuration is termed as syngeotactic, means there is a alternating sequence. Okay, in this picture you can see the green molecule monomers molecules and yellow molecules positions in a alternating way. So these are the example of syngeotactic. Now the atactic. A random arrangement of substituents groups is referred as a atactic, means there is a randomness, there is no sequence, a proper sequence not maintained in this atactic polymer. Now the degree of polymerization. Number of repeating unit in the polymer chain formed is called the degree of polymerization, denoted by N. For example, polyethylene, that is C2H4-olein, where N stands for degree of polymerization. Now we if we assume the molecular weight of polyethylene is M, equal to small n multiplied by m0, where m0 is the molecular weight of monomer. Okay, and the strength of the polymer can be increased by increasing dp, means strength of the polymers is directly proportional to the degree of polymerization. When high dp, the polymer is hard and heat resistant, and low dp, the polymer is soft and gummy. The next one is a simple numericals according to degree of polymerization. If we assume molecular weight of polyethylene M equal to 28,000 and molecular weight of repeating unit, that is M0, equal to 28. Now M equal to N multiplied by M0, thus N equal to M by M0. So 28,000 divided by 28 equals to 1000. So degree of polymerization denoted by N equal to thousands for the polyethylene. That's all, and this is the reference from where I take the all thinking. Thank you very much.